Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to multi-boot on your Raspberry Pi by using a piece of software called PINN. This software allows you to install multiple operating systems to the single storage device. When you start up your Raspberry Pi, PINN will prompt you on which of these operating systems you want to boot into. If you don't select any operating system, it will boot to the last one that you selected. PINN is easily one of the best ways to multi-boot multiple operating systems on your Raspberry Pi. Best of all, it is incredibly easy to use. To install PINN to our Raspberry Pi, we'll be making use of the Raspberry Pi Imager. You can download this software by going to https://www.raspberrypi.com/software. Download the version of Imager for your current operating system and install it. Once installed, you'll want to open up the software and then click the Choose Device button. This will show you a list of different Raspberry Pis. Select the model that you plan on using, as this will ensure that it downloads the correct version that will run on your device. In our case, we're using a Raspberry Pi 5. Once selected, you'll want to click the Choose OS button and then scroll down and click the MISC Utility Images option. Next, click the option labeled PINN and then click PINN again. With the multi-boot PINN image selected, you'll now want to click the Choose Storage button and then select the storage device you want to install it to. Remember that any data that exists on this drive will be wiped during the imaging process. With everything set, click the Next button. You'll see a warning that all the data on your selected storage device will be wiped. If you're happy to proceed, click Yes. The imaging process itself shouldn't take very long, as PINN is a very small piece of software. Once PINN has been installed to your Raspberry Pi's storage device, you'll see a message that it has been successful. You can now plug this storage device into your Raspberry Pi and power it on. The first time you start up your Raspberry Pi with PINN, you'll be greeted with a list of operating systems that you can install. All of these will work out of the box and will allow you to easily multi-boot between them. PINN gives you access to a wide range of different operating systems, and you can switch between these using the tabs at the top. Additionally, PINN does come with support for Wi-Fi. Click the Wi-Fi button in the menu bar to bring up the options. With this menu, you'll find that it will automatically find and detect your local Wi-Fi networks. We have an Ethernet connection, so we don't need to bother with this, so we'll be just hitting the cancel button. We will now choose two random operating systems that we want to install to our Raspberry Pi. In this case, it will be Ubuntu and Raspberry Pi OS. As you select operating systems to install, you'll want to pay attention to the bottom left corner of the window. This tells you how much space you have available and how much space is required to install your selected operating systems. In our case, you can see that it already needs 14 gigabytes for the two operating systems that we selected. Once you're happy to proceed, click the Install button in the top left-hand corner. You'll now see a warning that the data on your drive will be wiped during the installation process. If you're happy to proceed, click Yes. You'll now see a list of all the operating systems that you intend on installing and how much space they require. You'll also be shown how much extra space will be allocated to these operating systems. By default, PINN will balance the remaining storage between your operating systems. You can manually change these values if you only need a certain operating system to have access to a small amount of storage. If you ever want to rebalance the remaining storage, just hit the Balance button. Once you are happy with everything, press the OK button to install these operating systems to your Raspberry Pi and set up multi-boot. How long the installation process takes will heavily depend on the speed of your storage device and the speed of your internet connection. We have sped up this for the video so you don't spend 10 minutes staring at an install screen. Once PINN has successfully installed your chosen operating systems, you'll see a message saying it has done so. Click the OK button to proceed to the multi-boot screen. On the Raspberry Pi multi-boot screen, you'll see every operating system that you've installed to your storage device. You'll be greeted with this screen every time you restart your Raspberry Pi. To boot a particular system, all you need to do is click it and then click the boot button. Here you can see that we have successfully booted into our first operating system, which is Raspberry Pi OS. Let's now reboot again to return to the multi-boot screen. Now to show that multi-boot does in fact work, let's now select Ubuntu and hit boot. As you can see, thanks to multi-boot, we have successfully booted up a separate operating system, which in our case was Ubuntu. PINN actually supports more than just the two operating systems, and you can install as many as you'd like. Let's now return back to PINN by restarting Ubuntu. If there's no user interaction during boot up, PINN will automatically start up using the last chosen operating system. At this point, hopefully you have a good idea of how you can easily set up multi-boot on your Raspberry Pi by making use of PINN. If you like this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.